My name's Jordan Hardy. I work for Dr. Jennifer Long at the University of California, Los Angeles. And I am a marine biologist by education who got lucky enough to be transplanted into a stem cell research lab. So we are working on a protocol, and when I say protocol, I mean directions that other people can follow on how to create a vocal cord in lab conditions that can later be transplanted into a patient and replace the damaged vocal cord that they currently have that may be making it hard for them to speak or swallow. I was born in South Lake Tahoe, California. I was born in the mountains. I grew up in a beautiful area with clean air and clean water. So the funny thing is I didn't have a whole lot of interest in biology in high school. I really disliked chemistry. I was terrible at physics. So I had one simple goal coming out of high school, and that was to go to college. I had no idea what I was going for. And I spent years exploring psychology, philosophy, anthropology, music, and I just kept changing my mind and had no idea, and that was okay because it eventually led me to where I was. So I enjoy swimming. I always have. And one day I was free diving in Lake Tahoe, and free diving means you just have a mask on and you go underwater and you hold your breath and you explore for as long as you can. And I came up and laid in the sun to dry, and I thought, this is what I love to do. How do I get paid to do this? And so I started off on my science career thinking I was going to be a wildlife photographer. And as I learned more and more, I realized that my passions were changing. So I've always really loved animals and I love the environment. However, I had an injury that changed my perspective, and I hurt my back in a manner that caused me a lot of pain for a long time. And suffering through that gave me more of a passion that I wanted to help people. Knowing what it was to suffer, and when your body shuts down in certain areas and cannot heal itself, I just wanted to give something back to humans and make it easier for people that might be in my position. My mission at Dr. Jennifer Long's lab is a lot of fun because I get to do all the hands-on stuff. So I get to take different solutions and chemicals and mix them together and create an environment that one-celled cells get to live in, and I get to take care of them and watch them grow. It's always a learning experience. It's a challenge, which I like, and since we always have something new going on, I don't get bored. I'm always learning. It's always increasing my experience, and it's always a lot of fun. So one day, say 20, 30, 50 years from now, I might have a friend who goes in and has a surgery involving the technique that we've developed. To me, I would love it just for myself, but I'd also love to brag about it a little bit and be like, I was part of that. I helped develop that technology that has saved your vocal cords, saved your voice.
You don't often get...
If I was to ask a young person what they want to do for the rest of their life, what they want to be when they grow up, the best answer that I could hear from them is, I don't know. It's okay not to know. I still don't know. I'm 30 years old, and I've done a whole bunch of different things with my education. The important thing is to figure out what makes you happy, and then figure out how to get paid for it. And it doesn't have to be a lot of pay, because when you love what you do, you never have to work another day in your life. And a degree in science is going to open up so many doors. I've taken my bachelor's degree. I've worked in the Philippines doing seagrass research. I've taught biology classes in Thailand. I've done botany in Oregon. I'm now doing stem cell research in Los Angeles, California. And all of that's because I decided to go for a biology degree, to go for what I love. And it's the best decision I ever made.